Good morning students, this is a video lecture for class 12th. Now today we are going to discuss about the magnetic field due to a solenoid. In previous lecture we have already discussed about the magnetic field due to a current carrying conductor due to a loop. Now today we are going to discuss about how can we find out the magnetic field around a solenoid or inside a solenoid with the help of Ampere's circuital law. Now, so first of all, as we know that whenever we want to find out the magnetic field around a current carrying conductor with the help of Ampere's circuital law, so first of all we have to imagine an Amperean loop. So first of all, inside this very solenoid, so suppose that this is any solenoid and current is flowing inside this very solenoid, current carrying conductor. So in this very solenoid, first of all we have to imagine an Amperean loop. So here we imagine an Amperean loop LMNO. This LMNO, Amperean loop, this LM is along the direction of the magnetic field. This sign LM is along the direction of magnetic field. MN is perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field. NO is parallel to the direction of magnetic field. And OL is perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field. An Amperean loop is considered in the shape of a rectangle. Here we imagine Amperean loop in the shape of rectangle, and it is very easy to find out the magnetic field around this. So whose one side is along axis, let it be LMNO. The rectangle be LMNO. This LM is along the direction of magnetic field. So here, what is the magnetic field? So first of all, according to the Ampere's circuital law, mu naught I is equal to rho's integral of B dl cos theta. So here first of all we want to find out the B dl. So here rho's integral of B dl. So one by one we integrate this all. So first of all we take this one, integration of this L to L, then M to L, then N to O and O to L. Just like a Gaussian surface and Gauss law, we use here Ampere's circuital law and Amperean loop. So first of all we find out the magnetic field of this one, this side individually. This side, and this side. So here it is the closed integral of this L to M and BDL cos theta, M to N BDL cos theta, N to O BDL cos theta, and O to L BDL cos theta. So here L to M, M to N, N to O, and O to L. So in this very figure, you see here, when we take out this BDL cos B and integration of DL cos theta, so theta becomes here 0 degree because this LM and the magnetic field are parallel to each other, so the angle between them is 0 degree, so the value becomes here cos 0 is equal to 1. And this B is constant, we take out this B, and from M to N, here M to N, finally what happens? Here dl cos 90 and value of the cos 90 is equal to 0 degree. And you see here this B, because there is not any current inside this very magnetic field, so there is not any magnetic field in this very area. So if the magnetic field becomes 0, so the total value becomes 0 here. This total value becomes 0. Reason what? This total value becomes 0 because the magnetic field is here 0. Now in third one, this O to L, where magnetic field B and the dl cos 90, so once again the value becomes 0. So finally here what? The total magnetic field around this is bl 0 plus 0 plus 0. It means this all term becomes 0. Finally we get what? Bl. The total value becomes bl. In a solenoid with turn density n, it means n turn per unit length. N turn per unit length. So if we want to find out the magnetic field at any point P inside this very solenoid, so we have the formula, and the formula become what? We have the formula, it is BDL, it is equal to mu naught I. So here it's mu naught I, and we got this value from here, so its value become B and L, and as we know that this mu naught I, so the current flowing to this per unit length, it become N turn I, so it become N I L. It become N I L. So L L get cancelled, and finally we got what? B is equal to mu naught N I. So this is the value of the magnetic field inside a current carrying solenoid. Now we are going to discuss what is toroid and how can we find out the magnetic field inside the toroid, outside the toroid, and on the toroid is a solenoid which is in the form of ring. Toroid, what is toroid? A toroid is a solenoid in the form of a ring. This solenoid is bent in the form of a circular ring. So this is known as a toroid. So what is the magnetic field outside the toroid at point P, in the toroid and inside the toroid? So we want to find out the magnetic field at point P1, P2 and P3 or P. So first of all we want to find out the magnetic field outside the toroid. What is the magnetic field outside the toroid? That is P1. So as you know, we are going to find out with the help of Ampere circuit law. So first of all we have to imagine or consider an Ampere loop. So first we consider an Ampere loop outside the toroid, and that is on P. So let's consider an Ampere loop concentric circle passing through point P, here point P1, outside the toroid. So the closed integral of BDL, so B is constant and DL become 2 pi r. This is the circumference of the circle, 2 pi r, and the current is 0. There is not any current passing through this. So the current becomes 0, finally this I becomes 0, so B becomes 0. So outside the toroid, the magnetic field becomes 0. Now what is the magnetic field inside the toroid? What is the magnetic field inside the toroid? So here we take out the B into 2 pi r is equal to mu naught I, and once again here I is equal to 0. So it becomes B into 2 pi r is equal to mu naught 0. So finally it becomes 0. So B is equal to 0. So inside the toroid also the value becomes 0. Now what is the P on the toroid? What is the P on the toroid? So when we want to find out the toroid, sorry, magnetic field on the toroid, point P, so magnetic field at point P, at point P on the toroid. So on the toroid we have already find out the magnetic field inside the solenoid in the previous topic. So it is B is equal to mu naught n I. We have already find out mu is equal to B is equal to mu naught n I. So once again we got this value here n is equal to n upon 2 pi r. So finally we got here B is equal to mu naught n I upon 2 pi r. So this is the magnetic field on the toroid. Outside the toroid, the magnetic field becomes 0. Inside the toroid, the magnetic field is 0. But on the toroid, the magnetic field is B equal to mu naught n I upon 2 pi r.